King StarBoard ST has become one of the most popular building materials because it works like wood with familiar woodworking tools and techniques. This video will give you a few important CNC tips to help you learn to deliver quality results with our polymer sheets. Tool manufacturers, such as Onsrud and Vortex, classify the King StarBoard family of products as soft plastic in their catalogs and information. This is important because the geometry of the bit changes given the material it is intended to cut. For most applications, you want to cut King StarBoard products with an upcut O-flute bit. O-flute bits tend to leave a quality finish over other styles of bits. You want to keep the cutting edge length of the bit as short as possible, determined by the gauge of the material, to keep chatter to a minimum. Chucking your tool in the tool holder as far as possible is also important in reducing chatter, but do not go past the shank. No cutting edge should be in the tool holder. For bits 1/4 inch to 1/2 inch in diameter, we keep the RPMs at 18,000 to 20,000 and the feed rate at 150 to 250 inches per minute. You'll find that RPMs and inches per minute necessary to achieve a quality cut vary from machine to machine. Your inches per minute is determined by the rigidity of the CNC machine you are using and the amount of material you are removing with each pass. If your RPMs are significantly different than 18,000 to 20,000, your inches per minute will also be different. It's a good rule of thumb, you should only cut as deep as the diameter of the tool to achieve a maximum quality. For 3/4 inch thick King StarBoard, we typically make 2 cuts with a 3/8 inch bit to go all the way through. Quality of appearance is not important, deeper cuts can be made. Depending on the quality of the first pass, which varies with the speeds and bits you decide to use, you may or may not find it necessary to make a finishing pass. If you find that a finishing pass helps, we recommend leaving 15/1000ths of an inch of material on the roughing pass. When profiling, it is best to use a bit with a rounded bottom. This helps reduce swirl marks in the material. Chip relief is also important. Wide profile bits may need to run at RPMs as low as 8,000 and inches per minute of 100 or less. Combination of sloping and arcing lead-ins is the best way to remove entry tool marks. Lead-ins should be sufficiently long relative to the depth of cut. This reduces pressure on the spindle, bit, and material itself. Usually no lead-out is the best option because it minimizes the upward pull on cut parts as the bit exits. When drilling with a CNC machine, you may have to experiment to come up with the right speeds for your machine. Using our software's pecking function, we drill at 4,000 RPMs, 75 inches per minute downfeed, and 1/8 inch deep per peck. This method works for both drill and end mill bits. The pecking motion and slow speeds allow for larger chips to be removed during each peck and keeps chips from jamming the bit or the hole. If you are surfacing a sheet or machining large pockets, there are several precautions you should take to reduce the chance of relieving too much stress in one area and bowing your sheet. To start, always begin at the inside of the sheet. This helps reduce the chance that the ends will bow up and cause you to lose vacuum suction. Ideally, you should surface the sheet on both sides to reduce the risk of the sheet bowing. Always surface and pocket before you cut pieces out so that maximum vacuum is available. Another technique that helps with bowing is to tape the edge of the sheet all the way around to the table. This will help prevent suction escaping from the edges. Jigs and clamps may be used in extreme applications where bowing may result. With an experienced CNC operator and these tips from King Plastic Corporation, you can easily fabricate King StarBoard sheets into nearly any application you can imagine. Please contact your hardwoods distributor or King Plastic Corporation today to learn more.